British Rail is putting a brave face on it today, describing their newly cut budget as tough but achievable. But the cost of achieving it will fall largely on the traveller. Fares will go up by at least 5%. That would mean a monthly season ticket from Dartford to London would go up from £67 to £70.35, and a monthly ticket from Brighton to London would increase by about £6, from £118 to £124. The first fare rise is expected in January. The government says the subsidy cut is designed to shift the burden of a loss-making rail service from taxpayer to traveller, an argument that carries little weight with the rail unions.
The taxpayers are also the travellers, so there's no saving to anybody.
The unions say that the budget cuts will lead to an inevitable deterioration in services, but the government say services should actually improve.
We do put hand in hand the fact that we are asking British Rail to give greater emphasis to quality standards, to punctuality, to cancellations, to cleanliness, and things of that sort in the provision of their services. And I think when people see those improvements, they won't begrudge an appropriate increase in fares.
And you're asking them to do all of this on less money?
They've done it over the last 3 years.
The minister's optimism is not shared by the travellers' watchdog body.
For every 100 people sitting, 35 can expect to stand. That's of concern to us. If these targets result in even worse loading targets, then passengers are not going to be at all happy.
And indeed, at Cannon Street this morning, they weren't.
If we have to stand every day and then pay more for it, it's a bit much.
It's okay paying the more if the service is better. But the service isn't any better the more you pay.
And the price increases, I don't think, reflect the service that we get at the moment.
So would you be prepared to pay more?
Unfortunately, we'll have to if it comes to that. But if it's a result of government policy, I'll probably vote for the government.
If ever proof was needed of the motorway's magnetic pull, it's... Oh, shit. Weren't you? Oh, sorry, I heard the click and I thought he's just, you know, off we set. If ever proof was needed of the motorway's magnetic pull, it's what's happening in Dartford. It's here that road meets water, with the prospect of a port that could become the gateway to Europe. Only last week, a £20 million ferry terminal was officially opened. And with the M25 providing fast access to towns in Britain and the continent just a few hours across the sea, the savings potential is vast. Dartford Council say transport businesses are queuing up to move to the area. One firm, which has relocated from the city, buses in half its workforce. I'm going to do this as separate, they can be butt joined, I think. A 240-acre transport and distribution business park is being built for completion in June, and three shopping centres in the surrounding area are also planned. 25 miles east along the M25, another building boom's taking place at Redhill and Reigate. Already with fast connections to London by rail and Gatwick Airport nearby. Nah, do that again. 25 miles east along the M25, another building boom's taking place at Redhill and Reigate. With fast rail connections to London and Gatwick Airport nearby, the new rail links are. Take three on Reigate and Redhill. 25 miles east along the M25, another building boom's taking place at Redhill and Reigate. With fast rail connections to London and Gatwick Airport nearby, the new links to the national motorway network are acting as a pipeline of prosperity. Planning experts believe the development would have come eventually, but at nothing like the pace which locals have seen recently. That development virtually reached saturation point. Has. Try again. That development has virtually reached saturation point and there's now a stop on further planning consent. In Reigate, the town centre has an entirely different image as it's a conservation area. But there's still been plenty of building nearby, leaving just one major site for future commercial development. And that's the lot.